Freestanding Tuck Hold.
The goal of this drill is to go from a straight handstand into a half tuck and hold that position. You can hold this from 1 second all the way to 10 seconds, really whatever you can hold. The most important thing is not the hold, is that you can recover back to a straight handstand. One of the good things about this drill is that even if you can hold it for 1 second and you dismount onto the ground, you are still kind of training the pathway of proper tuck up and tuck down. But again, the idea is you are on a straight handstand, your feet are pointing up towards the sky, and your shins are perpendicular to the ground. The intention is to maintain that line with your shins as much as possible as you lower your knees down. We want to avoid changing the position of your feet, meaning that if we don't bend the knees and the hips at the same time, at the same ratio, the feet are going to start pointing back behind you. The goal is to keep your legs in front of your body as you're lower down. If you were doing this drill against a wall, you wouldn't be touching the wall with your feet at any point. Do your best to go to a full straight handstand between each repetition. The drill is straight handstand, half tuck, back to your straight handstand. With time, we are going to lower the knees even more, which is going to create or is going to be working with your compression, which means the lower the knees go to the ground, as long as we're keeping the feet in front of our body, the more we are encouraged or the more we have to curl on our lower back to engage our belly and to bring the ribs in to be able to hold the handstand. You will notice that there's a slight lean back from your entire body, all the way from your hands to your hips, through your hips. So allow that small leaning back action to happen as you tuck down, and then recover that lean as you tuck up.